Okay, welcome back to part 6 of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. In this 6th and last part of the lesson, we're going to take a look at the user experience component of the site. And now the user experience component, as I've said before, comprises a number of elements. The first element is the ease of navigation, or the ease of understanding where you are on the site. So we're going to learn how to create navigation that is easily followed by our customers. And so, as I've said before, that includes not just the menu system, but it also will include a system of creating these breadcrumbs so that a customer can find out where they are in the system and can easily navigate around. They can click on these things and then click back to the full product information. They can go back and take a look at other products, and they can essentially maneuver their way around the site using this breadcrumb system without ever getting lost. Obviously, there's a search element of this site too, so if we want to look for a book about bananas, the search results brings us back both the books about bananas and also an article from the blog about bananas. And then we have the sitemap, which we've called important links here, but it's a sitemap that takes us to the main sections of the site. So we can find our way around easily down here from the bottom, as well as little teaser navigation elements like recent posts, for example. The second part of this system is customer support. Now, in my opinion, customer support should be as plain as the nose on your face, especially when you're purchasing something like that. And so not only is it going to reside up here in the top level so we can see what's going on, but also so is company information about us. And our contact information, telephone, email, and physical location is going to be a very prominent element of the site. People feel a lot more comfortable if they know where the company that they're dealing with is, so no post office boxes, but physical addresses, real phone numbers, real methods of obtaining support easily found on the site. For products, we will be converting the WordPress system of comments into customer reviews. So if a customer likes the book and wants to add a review to the book, they can do so. And they can do so using the native WordPress functionality, which means that there can be threaded comments and all the rest of those sorts of things that you can have in WordPress. And yet, when you're on a blog post and you want to comment on a blog post, it's not going to show up as a review of any of the products. So this gives our customers a way of participating in the site. And then finally, we have clarity. And clarity has three big elements. The first element is, where am I? So if somebody is searching for something and Google returns the result that brings them to your a post on your blog, they need to know where they are, and we're going to give them clues as to where they are. Let's say, for example, they end up on the Cherry's blog post. We're going to give them clues as to where they are. Clues first in the URL. We'll tell them very clearly that they're at this location and they're looking in the categories of fruit and they're looking at an article called Cherries. We're going to show it in the breadcrumbs. So again, the breadcrumb trail shows the same thing. We are going to show it in the titles so that our titles are clearly identify what it is the customer is looking at. And then we're going to have graphic elements. So for example, if we are over at the books section, we can tell that we are at a page that is below this catalog. And if we hover over this, we can see that we are at the books. And that's because we've given it different colors. We also have set off the blog by having a different page format with the blog. So there's other information on the blog than there is, say, at the home page. And we'll also use other kinds of styling so that it's clear to a user that you're looking at a catalog. Not only does it say catalog, but this also even looks like a catalog. All right, so does this. This looks like a stacked product catalog. And our other catalog looks more like a vertically stacked catalog. So it's clear that from the visual cues, what's going on here, what it is that we're looking at. The second element of clarity is, where do I want to go from here? And again, not only do we have sort of clear navigation up here at the top, but we also have this navigation which will allow them to step back into another place, perhaps even home, but allow them to maneuver their way through the site. And the search function and the sitemap function will all contribute significantly to helping our customers understand where it is they want to go from wherever they are on the site. And then finally, we're going to talk about what's preventing me from either knowing where I am or knowing how to go where I want to go. And so we'll be looking at distracting elements that can draw your attention away from the critical part of the page. We're going to look at avoiding the lack of coherent organization. And different problems with navigation systems that make traveling through the website counterintuitive. Okay, so that wraps up lesson one of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. There are 12 lessons in this series where we will be looking at all of the elements that we have overviewed here in depth, including how to create this entire website. So I hope you found this lesson valuable, and I hope you'll be successful in creating your own e-commerce website.